the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
There is no problem too big God cannot solve it. There is no mountain too tall He cannot move it. And there is no storm too dark God cannot calm it.
For our Goodnight message on this Monday, the 4th of April 2022, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University, Rome, Italy, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this encouraging and strengthening message in line with the first reading of today, entitled, God Will Vindicate You. Today we read from the deuterocanonical text of Daniel chapter 13 verse 1-9 and then verse 15-17, then 19-30 and verse 33-62, the story of Susanna. It is a lovely story that is only found in those Bibles which have an extension of deuterocanonical texts. We see a virtuous woman by the name of Susanna who refuses to bow down to the sensuous life of men who wanted to abuse her sexually. She said no, even when she knew very well a no meant her own death, because these men had grown old in wickedness. And when she said no, she was condemned to death by being accused of committing adultery. And Susanna, a righteous woman, still clung to her God, expecting the vindication from the Lord. She was being led to death, to execution, when Daniel, a young prophet, stopped them to review the whole condemnation process. And in that review, we are told those men were found wanting, and they ended up being condemned and Susanna set free. I don't know what your situation is like today. Maybe you are also facing a situation where you are falsely accused like Susanna. I want to let you know God alone will vindicate you. No matter how much you may try to justify yourself, I want to let you know it is only God who can plead on your behalf. I don't know. Maybe you have been falsely accused. So was Jesus. They called him all sorts of names: a glutton, a drunkard, a friend of low-life sinners. They accused the Apostle Paul of being a madman, a fool, and a babbler. Jesus called Satan the father of lies. When you are committed to doing God's will, Satan will attack you and use people to do it. Don't get discouraged and don't despair. God will vindicate you. His word says, no weapon turned against you will succeed. You will silence every voice raised up to accuse you. These benefits are enjoyed by the servants of the Lord. Their vindication will come from me, says the Lord. If you insist on retaliation, God will back off and leave you to it. But when you put the situation into His hands, the test can result in a testimony to His goodness and grace in your life. So instead of wasting time complaining, pray. Let your favor shine on your servant. In your unfailing love, rescue me. Don't let me be disgraced, Lord. I call out to you for help. Let the wicked be disgraced. Silence their lying lips, those proud and arrogant lips that accuse the godly. How great is the goodness of the Lord! You have stood up for those who fear you. How great is the goodness you have stored up for those who fear you. You lavish it on those who come to you for protection, blessing them before the watching world. You hide them in the shelter of your presence, safe from those who conspire against them. You shelter them in your presence, far from accusing tongues. Psalm 31, verse 16 to 20. Simply pray, Father, I put the situation into your hands today. Vindicate me. Whatever that situation you are facing where you feel unfairly treated, just say, Father, I put this situation into your hands today. Vindicate me. As he vindicated Susanna, he's going to vindicate you. As he vindicated all those who cried to him, he's going to vindicate you. Trust him. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.
There is no mountain too tall, he cannot move it. And there is no storm too dark, God cannot calm it. There is no sorrow too deep, he cannot soothe it. Sister, that